Hello guys, and welcome back. As you can see, I have finished making all the rope ladders. Everything is done. It was very, very time consuming and also very, very boring. And I have counted down the nuts I needed to make all these rope ladders, the total nuts, for all three masts, for all three levels. They are 2,548 nuts. It's driving you insane, I can tell you that. Now, next thing in line is to make the yards. This is the main mast, the main yard. Here you can see, main mast, the main yard. Each picture of the yards shows the yard in two positions. Here you can see it from the front, I believe, because this is where you see the upper reinforcement, and here we have it from the top, where you can see the reinforcement. It's at the top. It's exactly the same yard, but it's in two different angles, so you can understand where the pulleys go, also the reinforcement, and we have to place a lot of pulleys. What I'm going to do is to make all the yards with you of the main mast, starting from here. This is the main. We have another one right here, and a couple at this level. Here we have two. You can see that. Here. This is a picture of the model. As you can see, we have 4 yards at the main mast, and at the front mast also. So what I'm going to do is make all the yards of the main mast with you, also the 2 yards that goes here for this vertical sail, and of course I will show you how to place them. Again, the main mast and the yard here at the vertical sail. All the others, and also the masts at the bow, the yards at the bow, I do not believe I need to show you how to fix them, how to make them. Maybe at the bow I will show you how to place them. So let me get my materials, and we'll start making the first yard. Well guys, here I am. This is the piece that I'm going to need for the main yard. It's 8 millimeters in diameter, and I have to cut it in 39.2 centimeters. As you can see, I have marked right here, so I'm going to cut it. I'm going to use this little saw. Let's sand down to make it even. Now let me show you something. This is going to be tough. As you can see here at the edges, I have to place these little pieces. These are 6 millimeters in diameter, so this means that this one from 8 must go to 6, but as you can see here, here we have, I believe, 8. Let me check. Here we have 7. This is 7 millimeters. to start from 8. So I have to trim it very little. Also here we have 5 millimeters. As you can see, it takes a curve, ends up here, and around here it needs a different trimming, so I can have 6. Don't know how to make this corner here. Okay, I'll find out, I'll try it, we'll do it together. So this doesn't need a lot of trimming and it's going to be hard. First of all, we mark the center. This is it. The center is right here. Doesn't need to be straight, just a mark to know from which part above and below we're going to trim. Okay, this is going to be hard. Now, let's see how it will come up. Got it. Now, let's try to make it vertical. Now, I have to do the other end as well. So I'll do that and I'll get back to you. This is the best I can get. Also, you can see here it broke on me, so I had to glue it. Very, very hard. It was one of the most difficult yards I ever made. Probably the most difficult one. And now I'm just at the middle part. I just made the main. I also need to make the other ones as well. So let me see what these pieces are and I'll get back to you. Let me show you something, guys. I just found out. Here, as you can see, we have one ring like this, and here we have another ring like this. The only problem, here are the 4 rings. These rings are required to support the upper part of the yard here. The only problem is that according to the plans, this must be 7 millimeters. This hole is 6. So there's no way in the world that I can get this thing through here and through over to this part right here. There's no way. It's 6 millimeters, this one 7. Can do that. Also, that's it. I can do that. So I'm thinking here
how to do it. Definitely this won't pass, go pass through here. Also I had a breakdown right here, so I cannot, this wood will not tolerate anymore. I have two choices. One choice is to trim all this yard all the way to the end evenly, so I can pass this ring over here. The second choice is to change the ring and make one of my own that will be definitely different, and it won't match the other ones. So what I'm going to do is trim this yard over here and make it even like all the yards that I've made so far, and I'm going to do the rest of them as well with the same way, so I can pass the rings up to here. So let me trim that. I just wasted a lot of time to make this, and there's no use. Let me trim that and I'll get back to you. So guys, I made it even. Here this little gap will be vanished, because here, as you can see, there's going to be tied a pulley, so this wall will be covered with rope, no one will be able to see it. Also the damage here has been covered up, so I don't even know if I fix it, I finish it, I won't even know myself that it was broken. Now these pieces here are 3 millimeters in diameter. As you can see, they're not, I don't have to trim them a lot, just to make them to be smooth, so that's easy. Here, these are going all the way that I want them to go, as you can see, and this one doesn't seem to be able to fit. So that means that this hole is not 3 millimeters. Let's open it up. Yeah. Perfect. So guys, before doing anything else, we have to place these supports. That's 1x3, they're cut in a length of 85 millimeters. These are these supports here, because we have to trim them and make them smooth, and that will be only I will be only able to do it with the power drill. So if I place these extra beams here, I'm not going to be able to do that, because this one won't rotate. So let's mark where to glue. I'm going to need one more, but as you can see, it's not the same like the others, and also I must make this even. That's not hard to do. Let me cut one more. Now let's see. Now let me prepare to make the sanding. Let's do it. Now, let's glue these. Don't have anything else to insert. Everything else can be done I see here some wires, but I can do that later, so no problem. Yeah, that's easy to do. Need some sanding. I need this to be straight. It is. Let's glue. And these metal rings definitely are going to be painted brown. Now, let's do the other one. Here we do not glue yet. First, we check position. Now, the alignment. Okay. First part is done. Now, before proceeding further, I have to place these wires here, as you can see. Any holes needed like this one would be done after the varnish. So, I have to place the wires and then I have to varnish it before proceeding to anything more. So let me get my materials and I'll get back to you. Now guys, next in line are to place some little hooks, rings like this, made out of wire. I need four, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 4. I have made one just to see how easy it is. It is not. So I'm going to make another one with you to show you how it's done. This thread here, it's 0.8 millimeters. So this thread will have to go through the ring. The ring, it's better to make it 1.5 millimeters, because if you make it 1 millimeter, it's going to be very narrow. So 0.5 millimeter won't make a difference at the looks, but it will make it easier to pass through. Now I have here a tip, it's 1.5 millimeters, and I have to make one like this one, as you can see here. Now this is hard, it's not easy. I believe I have too much. I need less. You cross the wire and you hold it up, not down, not close to the ring. And you start twist. As you can see, I move it lower and lower to make the ring to become like I want it to be. That's it. Make it straight as much as possible. Now let's see the length. Right, exactly where I want it to be. Now let's place it on the other side. This one will be cut off, so no worries. Around. Tighten it as much as you can. Now let's cut off what we don't need. Let's separate it, not to make a mistake. This is it, this is the one, okay. Make it straight.
Let's place it at the correct position. It's right there. Let's make it to be aligned. It's wire, so you can bend it anytime. Now let's glue it. Do not use any glue here. You have to leave this to be able to move, as you can see, because underneath here we're going to stitch the sail. So if you glue it, you have to unglue it. Now this is the way to make it. I have to make a couple of more, and I'll get back to you to see what else we need to place here before varnish it and place pulleys and strings. Here we are. As you can see, I've placed all four of them. Until the final moment that I will place this onto the ship, these are going to be bent a million times, but no problem with that. It's just wire. I can bend it and I can push it to be at the exact position I want it when I'll place this onto the ship. Now this is the same yard, the main yard, but it's a different angle. As you can see, this angle is made for two reasons. One, to see how the pulleys are going, and the second reason is to see that these were not visible before. It's these two parts, it's prefixed, they are prefixed, they are made of metal, they're going to be painted brown as these support holders here. But before doing that, I have to glue them in position. So as you can see, I have the supports above, like this one, and these are vertical here. So what I have to do is place this right here and mark the position of each piece. I'm going to make sure okay, they are correct. Let's do a test run before gluing. Perfect. Let's glue. Done. So this concludes the phase one of making the yards. As you can see, I've made all the woodwork and metal work for the main yard. All I have to do now is varnish it, of course, use sealer before, and I'm ready to place all the pulleys, ropes, and everything I need before placing onto the model. So this concludes this video. There will be
two, maybe three more, no, three definitely more, maybe four videos for the next of the yards. This is the main yard of the main mast. I have three more yards of the main mast to show it to you, and a couple of yards for the vertical piece of sail at the stern. So, thanks again for watching, guys. See you soon with the next yard.